Chinese companies are huge churners of mobile phones, but they don't have a brand themselves. Micromax is today. In India, they are probably the second largest brand after Samsung.
Yes.
In Asia, they're the fourth largest brand. Okay. What was that one feature that catapulted Micromax into recognition way back in 2008, 2009? And there are business case studies on this. All they talked about for the first phone, the X100, was 30 days battery backup. Everybody had that. What do you mean 30 days? And then I launched a not so popular dual SIM Chinese handset in the Bharti brand name when I was at Bharti. We never sold it in any of the metro markets because that was targeted for upcountry markets. We did. We reached to a spot where we were doing about 400 crores of business in a year from scratch. Was there is no consistent power outside of within. Beyond 150 kilometers of Delhi, there is no power. Mm-hmm. And at that point, it happens. I don't know what is happening now, but there was hardly any power. That's the advantage they have. And then you have all the portal on SharePoint. How many of you know about SharePoint? Right? Worked on that, developed that, seamless. You want to do workflow, SharePoint. You want to do content management, SharePoint. You want to do business intelligence, performance point. That's how they're creating that ecosystem. And then if you want to a consumer, then you walk into the Xbox space, Windows, Surface, Windows. That's what's getting created. And for the only thing that didn't work for Windows is the entire ecosystem as such, other than being everything else work, for it working. Okay? So that's another point that you need to be sure of. And going forward, you need to start looking at these three or four companies and how they do things differently. Most importantly, Amazon, Google and Apple. Samsung will largely be a hardware play. They're trying to do a couple of services that will not happen, but these three companies are something that you always need to look up to and understand, at least in the foreseeable future. And when I say near to midterm, I'm saying for the next 12, 18, 24 months, there is going to be considerable play that's going to happen in these three companies. And that's something that you always should follow, and at least I do that and have it. Slightly busy slide, but just to give you a sense of what the trends are. I'm not going to talk about it in too much detail because I need to move on to something very important here. So you have wearable computing, Google Glass, Sound. Galaxy Gear, what else?
Sony Watch.
Which was the first example of wearable computers? First example, less than 2 years ago.
The Google Glass.
Google Glass happened last year.
So Pebble?
Yes. That's all. Pebble. iPod with that Nike thingy. Oh. So you have that. You have your iPod, you're running, and then everything gets done, and you say, okay, now these many kilometers are done. And people take great pride in putting it up on Facebook every day in the morning, and I keep questions in the part and say, I should be running more. Security and compliance issues. Another big, huge trend. Okay? How do you authenticate on the web? How do you authenticate or at a premise, how does that information on usage patterns to identify any malware that is happening or any out of turn usage patterns, denial of service issues, all of these are now becoming huge concerns for organizations. Manage the application layer, manage the content that is getting demonstrated. Why is it important to look at content? Because in the enterprise environment, there are certain norms in terms of what sort of content can you actually access, what sort of applications can you actually run. Okay, because at the end of the day, the organization is providing you a service by giving you a mobile network to computer. And then they need to, and of course then there are all these regulatory concerns in terms of what sort of data you can access, not access. All those boundaries have to be created. It's not important enough to do it only on device, it's also not important to look at the content. Your product requirements, but always try and see what is the requirement that is satisfying, and then some more. So please don't confuse
your product requirements with what your customer requirements. Because if your product requirement only matches customer requirements, it's not going to succeed. But on the contrary, if it oversells the product requirement against the customer requirement, it still will not sell because customers will get completely overawed by the fact that it's yao. Okay? You should basically combine what is possible with what is possible. Innovation is not equal to value. You may keep on innovating, but the customer sees no value, he is not going to buy. One example, recent example. Anybody heard of a robotic cleaner, window cleaner for residences?
Floor
and what window cleaner?
Yes.
Coming from a company by the name of?
Milagro
is run by Rajiv Karwal, who is one of the most eminent alumni of this institute, 84 batch. Also the recent convener, if not the current convener, the recent convener of the alumni association. Great innovation. Honestly, if you ask me, in this closed room and probably in front of Rajiv, I'll say, won't work. Why? Our houses are different. Our houses have grime, dust, okay? Perpetual dust, fine dust. What does a robotic cleaner do in the US? Largely carpeted. Okay. Fine brush. You normally, there's no dust outside the house, so there can be no dust inside the house. The sole of your shoes are always black, they're always black. Sole of our shoes are always white when we come home.
Okay. Like dishwasher in India.
Well, I would love to have a dishwasher today. I'm sick and tired of doing dishes in the night here. Yeah, but you're right. Till some time back, because of our cooking conditions, greasy dishes, haldi ghadar, never happened. So innovation without a clear purpose is simply technology looking for a problem to solve. That's long sentence. If you ask me, I cannot spell it out without reading it again. But the core point is, what is it that you are trying to deliver at the end of the day? Don't look at one small problem. Look at the larger benefit. What will a robotic cleaner do? Can light me the floor soft no? Right? Dishwasher mein agar bartan saaf nahi ho to phir nikal ke sukhe rakho. Kya hota dishwasher? First you scrub. So take it out from the water. Man. Water is not that cold. The reason you put dishwashers in US is because half the time the water is sub-freezing. And they need to do that. Right? And what does it do? You need to scrub it. Then you put it, it brings some steam, it brings some gush of water. Thank you so much. You can sterilize bottles. How many of you, wrong audience, but I sterilize my daughter's bottles in non-boiling water. My mom used to kill me. Garam pani mein daal. I said, no, I don't need it. Why should I put plastic in boiling water? It's going to become carcinogenic after some point. But those are the thoughts. Innovation needs to happen in context of a vision and a strategy of your organization. Could you have today, in hindsight, even think that a company like a Micromax or a Spice would have brought out an iPod? That was Apple's vision. What did it? They were MP3 players before iPod came out. Right? Good ones. Creative had one. Creative went and then copied iPod, that's a different story. But they had
one.
CD man was there, Walkman was there. But what was the clear innovation that Apple did, brought in the system? Simplicity of design. Design. Everything you talk about Apple is all design. They have not brought out any revolutionary product in terms of a product, new product to the market. Everything was available. iPad was not the first touchpad that came to the market. Apple brought iPad by bringing simplicity. Laptops were available. Desktops were available. Phones were available. What they did was bring it simple. That is innovation. Now that innovation, if you overdo it, will give zero value to someone. Okay. One example of innovation versus value, you brought out the first CD man that Sony brought out. Never worked. Why? Because when you were running, when you're listening, you
get
CD in the chart.
So
innovation, yes. Limited value. When I said you are not the Spice customer, you don't even know what the Spice customer is. Honestly, you have never even seen him work. I'm not boasting him, but my eyes opened up when I did the entire Maharashtra sector. I opened up the market in Maharashtra in December of 2010. And that's when I realized what are people looking for in a phone and how phones are sold. Battery. First thing people say, will you customize the phone for me when I buy the phone because I don't know how this thing works. Okay, that's innovation in selling. I would say, ₹1400 ka phone is simple, let's push it in the market. Why? Because it's me too. So I'm now switching back whatever I've taught. उन्होंने फोन निकाला हम भी 1400 का फोन निकालेंगे उन्होंने मेन्यू में 9 ऑप्शन रखी थी हम 11 ऑप्शन रखे चल बेचते हैं हम गए मार्केट में हमारे पास ये फोन है तो सर ये तो सब ठीक है पर ये मेन्यू के अंदर में आपने निंबस निकाला है बिकॉज आई नेवर थॉट निंबस वाज इंपॉर्टेंट प्रोडक्ट निंबस इज दैट और फॉर दैट मैटर इन गुजरात जोक्स देयर वाज दिस वन एप्लीकेशन समबडी डेवलप्ड The dirtiest of jokes would come in Gujarati and people will actually pick it up and the bell that I was running at that point in time was bordering with Gujarat and all of them said, wo application ki to chhe. Sorry, was nahi pick it up. So you yourself are not your representative customer. But what is important in this case is you should do as much, that is the application piece, but you also should understand how will you people perceive your device or your service. Do pilot testing. Do user acceptance test. Do that piece before you bring the device or bring the service or bring the solution to the market. Sorry, nobody noticed that. I immediately went back to mobile phones again in my examples. The other piece is your now this example of what I'm doing on this real estate piece that I talked about, the first example I put. I am not a real, I think I will buy a property in a certain manner. When I went to Lodha, they said, look, I don't want all this visualization stuff. That was the biggest eye-opener. I suddenly saw Lodha Group moving away as a prospective customer. Suddenly I saw prospects of selling to Lodha suddenly dim. Why? Because they said, look, we don't want all this visualization. Why? Because he said, I only make designer residences. My residences are designed by Ivana Trump, by Jade Jagger, by some Giorgio Armani's great grandson. Okay? When I sell property, I sell designer residences. I tell them, this designer has built it. If you have the money, come buy it from me. Simple insight. I thought, because it's Lodha, somebody has 8 crores to spend, we will go, we will do visualization, I will get 1 crore from that business. Said, zero. Lodha said, we don't want it. But the minute I said, look, you can now devise commercial spaces, office spaces, where you basically sell shell space. And then if somebody wants to come and visualize how an office would look like, will this application work? He said, yes, this will work. And immediately got up, shook his hands, thank you, and said, I'm coming back in 2 weeks. So always put yourself against your customer and understand what is your customer looking for. You are not a representative sample. You will always miss that small insight till you such time that you actually go and intimately talk to a consumer group or your representative sample of your customer. In a holistic sense of the word. They will not teach you this in your class. Product management means we will hire one AC Nielsen or a Marv or an ORG and they'll say, we have now understood the market, this is what the trend looks like, this is a qual benefit, these are quant benefits, let's go. Okay? There is a difference between customer and user. We interchangeably talk about customers. My customer wants this. But okay, I want it. Who's the user? And I'm not, I'm tempted to take a mobile example, but I'm not going to take it. So you decipher it for yourself. So identify what your user looks like. Child, adult, gender, socioeconomic class. Okay? Whether they have the propensity to buy versus propensity to use. What will they do for usage? And so on and so on. Okay. One thing got mixed here. Feature is not equal to benefit. I have amazing features. If it doesn't do anything to your to addressing the consumer benefit, it will not sell. Okay? So don't get absorbed by